Live from the internet, it's Knoxkast.
God damn you, Matt. This is my show. You can't treat this like Mattcast. This isn't Brooke's cast. This is Knoxkast. Hold on, let's start over. Okay. Hello, I'm Knox, and this is a Knoxkast episode 33. See, you screwed me up.
But it's really Mattcast.
This is Knoxkast.
It's not Knoxkast.
Jason was around here.
It's Knoxkast.
Screw all y'all, it's Jasoncast.
Damn.
It's Knoxkast. Wait, it's been Knoxkast for almost a year now.
I say we change it to Knoxkast.
No, as long as it's not stupid Brookscast. Happy with that.
How about Brookscast? That's way better than Brooks, especially stupid Brookscast, because Brookses tend to be, you know.
Yeah, but that wouldn't make any sense because stupid. Your name is Brooks.
No, it's not.
Name is Matt Brooks. Or Matt Brookerston.
Die in a fire while impaled on rusty nails.
I've already done that, Matt.
Die of explosive diarrhea?
I ended up on this show.
Well, welcome to the episode. We got a special episode for you today.
I'm on.
You know, we've got an episode today that Brookers is really going to hate.
Yes.
Just loathe.
Because I'm here.
If she listens to it.
Which she won't.
No.
And if you are listening, hi.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm your supreme overlord.
I'm Knox. I'm Knox. You said you wanted to slit my throat. And then you deleted the message.
I wish someone had caught a screenshot of that, because I didn't actually see that.
Yeah, apparently, well, supposedly she posted a little thread on her forum saying that she wanted to slit my throat.
That chick is crazy.
She called me out.
This was Tom Hutt saying this, so.
Who?
Tom Hutt.
That's, who's that?
Robert's,
is that like Jabba the Hutt's brother?
No, that's my webmaster.
Oh. Hi, Tom.
He told me this, so I didn't see it myself.
I don't know, Tom doesn't really lie. I mean, he's kind of an over-exaggerator.
It's Jabba the Hutt.
Maybe kind of a Hitler at times, but he is not a liar. Hitler never lied.
You can't mess with the Hutts, man.
Hitler never lied. He was just...
We'll get a bounty hunter on you.
Yeah, so anyway, I was not expecting to have us do another
hate-filled...
Especially when two people got mad at us.
I know. I was not expecting to do another episode on this, but we got a series of emails that kind of restarted this whole thing. Emailed from a person... who emailed us anonymously.
Awesome.
And apparently they know Brooker. They know Brooker's in real life, or have met her in real life. Apparently this person is an actor and was cast for a part in a movie that Brooker is, or a television special or something that Brooker is trying to get produced. Well, apparently, this person is not really fond of Brookers himself.
Yeah.
So he sent us some stuff. It's actually been... He emailed us like 3 weeks ago. But,
you should read those emails.
But I totally forgot what any of them say. Hold on.
You have them?
Yeah, he says, I was recently signed on to do a movie with Brooke. Yeah. And he attended a rehearsal. Apparently they spoke and they emailed each other back and forth, and
apparently they didn't have good crafty.
No. And apparently he wasn't very fond of her after talking to her for enough time, apparently. But anyway, he sent us some emails that she wrote. They might
read
give
them.
You an insight into the mind of Brookers. Apparently, there's people who know her in real life who don't like her. So, because we honestly don't know anything about her when we started this crusade against her.
I knew less than Jace.
Yeah, I know. He didn't know anything. I told him about 5 minutes before we started recording about all this.
Peer pressure.
But apparently we might have actually been right about some of this stuff. like
interestingly enough,
with this blind hatred that we have might have actually had some backing to it that we were not aware of.
Yeah.
Go figure.
Yeah. So anyway,
you're just doing this to be stupid.
So here's some of the emails that I found kind of amusing from Brooker. This is Brooker wrote to this guy. Here's one. I'm just going to read some interesting snippets from these because they're really, really long. This is what she wrote. Some of the things we are taught in school to be solid fact, such as the midnight ride of Paul Revere, pretty much all just fabricated lies. I have no clue what the real guy's name was who really rode all those miles on horseback warning that the British were coming, but I remember Paul Revere's name. Why? The reason why you remember Paul Revere's name is because that actually was his name. go to Wikipedia and search Paul Revere, and that's the guy's name.
Yeah, it's like even a poem that goes along with it to help you remember.
Yeah, well,
the name.
Truth is that the story is over exaggerated as most legends are, except the basis behind it is entirely true. Paul Revere, along with some other people, were hired to go and warn.
It's like three people.
The Redcoats were coming.
Two of them had less than memorable names.
Yeah, and so, but yeah, his name is Paul Revere. So Brooker, just in case you're listening to that, this you might not want to tell that to too many other people, because if they actually look it up, then
yeah, don't make a video blog about it yet.
No, actually, do totally make a video blog.
Yes, please.
But yeah, so I mean, I agree that that oftentimes teachers will teach certain things in class that aren't entirely accurate, except this is not one of those times. Anyway, then she says, speaking on the topic of censorship, which she wasn't actually speaking on the topic of censorship in this email. I don't know where that came from. Speaking on the topic of censorship and all that goofy two-shoes type crap, well, I'm pissed NBC has censored my work once again. Every single time I send something into them lately, it's wrong this and wrong that, and this is wrong and that is wrong. I'm losing my mind. Apparently the stuff that she's sending to NBC, the ideas and stuff, is being censored or dismissed. And we'll get to more of that after these emails, because we might have discovered the source and reason for that. As to why NBC is giving her so much trouble over her material. We'll get back to that, so remember that. Okay, she mentions that she's now homeless.
Awesome.
Yeah, apparently she pissed off her parents and got kicked out of her house. She says that she was kicked out of her house. I was literally booted out of my house, one and oh my. My mom says I'm a terrible person because I don't do the dishes that her lazy fat boyfriend makes. I'm never even home to eat, and because apparently I put my feet on her brand new $1,000 furniture. So according to her, she was kicked out of her house because she doesn't do the dishes. I'm assuming there's actually more to that.
There usually is, you know, girls.
Yeah.
This is the beginning of a beautiful prostitute story.
Oh, I hope not. Okay, let's see. I might even consider putting my chewing gum on eBay to see what it gets. I'm desperate for money.
See? See? I'm desperate. Everybody remember this. I'm desperate for money.
If you see, she might put her chewing gum on eBay. So, yeah, so that's that, yeah. But anyway, so she's complaining that she's now homeless, and she actually apparently moved in with her writer, Joe. The guy who's helping her write her stuff for NBC, I guess. She moved in with him.
Yeah, who happened to be like a... He was like a major Brooker fanatic, right?
I guess. I think he
was basically my Miles.
He might have been a fan or something that she ended up writing with, or... I have no idea. All I'm getting is from what this guy told me. So I'd like to state right here that I don't even know if any of this is real. I'm assuming it is because it all sounds incredibly real, and the stuff that he sent me is all on the level and seems to be verifiable, except, again, it could very well be an elaborate hoax.
Dear Brookers!
So I'm getting that out of the way just
I'm
for...
I'm your greatest fan!
For liability purposes, this is all speculation.
That'd be a pretty well thought out.
Love me.
Yeah. Well. Anyway. After she says that she's homeless now, she writes him another email, talking about complaining about the homeless. She says, as far as the homeless thing, I never give money to homeless people. Money is usually the last thing they need. So, she's homeless now, and she needs money. And then she writes him an email saying, I never give homeless people money. Money is the last thing they need.
Man, I need money because I'm homeless, but man, and F those homeless people.
You don't have to worry about that, Brookers.
And I'd like to remind people that she did earlier have a thing where she asked her fans to donate her money so she could buy a car.
She raised $4,000, right?
Yeah, she raised a couple $1,000s that her fans gave her to buy a car. But she's homeless now, and apparently having money problems.
So, what happened to her car that her fans bought?
I don't know. I'm assuming that she's not incredibly good with finances, but I'm not...
4 + 4 is...
Well, she said in her... The video that started all this, the Hi, My Name Is, she said that she's never actually had a job until she was, like, 18 or something, and I'm assuming she doesn't have a job now. However, her money management might not be perfect, but she was just kicked out of her house, so that could put a strain on things. Yeah,
I've never had a job.
I think she's got to have had a job before.
Mm-hmm. I've never had a job.
Yeah, you haven't.
I haven't.
Talking about all this, God, she sucks so much because she doesn't have a job. Oh yeah, I haven't.
Guys,
I didn't say she sucks because she didn't have a job.
No, but we did.
Yeah, but we've had jobs.
No, actually, Matt did. I've been a little more kind. Matt's been pretty hateful this episode.
Yeah,
I've just been hateful to her stalker, dude.
Yeah. Okay, and then she says, at the end of this email, another good Hollywood quote that I've always enjoyed, and I don't remember who said it, but it goes something like, I don't care what you say about me, just so long as you spell my name right. So I'm going to make sure that we spell her name right in the episode title.
Oh my god, I feel so shallow now for... Knox, go ahead and call me Brooks. Go ahead.
Brooks!
Thank you.
Suck.
Thank you. I do suck, thank you.
So she says, I don't care what you say about me, just so long as you say your name right. So we're gonna give her that. We're gonna absolutely spell her name completely right. I think it's Brooke Allison. I think her first name is actually something else. I have to look it up. But we will make sure that we spell her name correctly. So yeah, this is some snippets from the emails, and he also sent us something else.
Naked pictures?
No.
No, we would get that to ourselves.
Oh, okay.
That would be right in the trash bin right there.
Hey, come on, Jason. Come on.
I do that secure delete where it writes over the file 3 times.
I mean, wait, I have a girlfriend. Wait, I wouldn't... Don't send me that crap, Jason.
Okay, so we got sent this script. Apparently, the person she's living with now, Joe, or Gusippi Pulgi... I don't know how to... Okay, GIUSCPPEPUGLIESE. I don't know how you pronounce this. I have
his real name's Joe, though.
I don't know if his real name is Joe or if this is his real name. One of them is his stage name, except he puts Giuseppe.
Joe's probably his stage name. It sounds like a real stage name to me.
It's maybe. I have no idea. But so anyway.
Joe can't be a stage
This guy
name.
Sent us this script totally that I don't know exactly what they're doing with this, but this is what the actor dude was cast in before he quit the project because he couldn't stand Brooker. I don't know exactly what this is going to be for. I think this might be one of the things that they're trying to get picked up by NBC, and you'll see why NBC is not picking it up. Besides the constant F-words and stuff like that, beyond that, it's probably the worst script that I've read since I've... Well, no, it's not the worst script that I've read. I've read a couple of other bad scripts.
Yeah, remember Villain.
Yeah, I mean, Villain was much worse, but...
Talk about wanting to drink diarrhea and gouge your eyes out.
I know, seriously. But it is actually pretty bad. I mean, it's... It reminds me exactly of all the scripts that were written in when I was at Full Sail.
It's most definitely not primetime network TV.
Oh, definitely not. I can't imagine that's if they are actually trying to sell this to NBC, then that's insane. I'm hoping that they're trying to sell it as something else.
It's not even like Saved by the Bell time slot material.
I don't know exactly what they're trying to do with this, but it's called a Roundabout.
When I wake up in the morning, da 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 da.
And,
yeah, save by the bell, man.
For copyright reasons, we can't give anyone this strip. We can't put it publicly. But what we can do is we can review it for you.
Right, because I'm saved by the bell.
Yeah. So we're going to review this. We're going to review this this classic script for you. We're going to go through it, and we're not actually going to read it.
We can't read it.
No, because I assume that would be a copyright violation.
Knox is going to instead.
Not that anybody else is going to read this.
But we can definitely review it.
Yeah. Not that anybody else is going to see this.
No one is ever going to see this made.
Yeah, no one.
It is. You know, one of the things that I noticed is
we went there. No
when
one.
People when people first start wanting to write like serious stuff, when inexperienced writers when they first try to do stuff, all the scripts end up exactly like this one. It's like I've read this same script 100 million times. In fact, I edited a movie that was exactly like this.
Yeah, that's right, you did.
And it's all bad. It's all terrible. When people the things that happens and this is a key to all of you, because I'm sure there's lots of talented writers out there who their first scripts, when they try to write seriously, are going to turn out exactly like this, and you've got to break free of that quickly. The first things they do is A, they put in some sort of either family or relationship drama that doesn't have, it's just drama. They think that by putting people yelling at each other, that's immediately good, and it's not. There has to be some sort of
Thanks, real world.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Just drama is not good. There has to be something going on, or there has to be some reason why we care. Because everyone has drama in their life, and just writing bad dialogue, you don't want to hear it when you're in it, and you certainly don't want to see it on screen. But not only that, but when people first start writing serious stuff, they think it's edgy to put as many curse words as they possibly can into the movie. And I think there's only a couple of writers who do that well, like Tarantino, etc. And most of the time, you're not writing good dialogue. You're just writing intense dialogue.
You're just venting most of the time.
Yeah, you're just venting. And also, as almost all serious indie scripts that are not good are all about someone has some sort of drug abuse or drug problem, because
what's wrong with me, man? F.
Gonna go do some drugs now.
or you have to add the lesbian angle, and then you're indie.
Yeah, well, that's I don't mind that. That's
of course you don't mind that.
We need more of that, but yeah. So the whole indie drug drama thing is overdone, and it's certainly not done well here. That's not saying that there aren't scripts like this that are good. It's just almost all of them are bad, and they're all the same too. Which is the problem. You see, it's not so much that it's the bad script that I'm against, it's the same bad script that I've read 100 times before.
Yeah.
So anyway, let's get on to review it. Do you have the script in front of you?
I'm on page number one.
What about you, Matt?
Where'd it go? Oh, here it is. Okay.
It doesn't even want to be read. That's how bad it is.
I've read it before. It's uninspiring.
Yeah.
Now, I haven't read it yet, and I don't think I'm going to.
We should disclose, there is a notice on this that says it's still in the writing process, and there's a lot of work to be done, and information will be changed or deleted. So they do say that it's unfinished, except, honestly, I don't think anything short of throwing it in the trash can could help this. So, that's my personal opinion. my personal opinion is that this is the worst script ever written.
One of them,
but at the moment, the worst script that I can remember.
Yeah.
Right after Villain.
Well, I don't know. I can remember one other one that was probably worse than this.
So it starts out... We're going to review this in great detail here. It starts out... It opens up, and you see someone's legs, okay? And then the camera goes and it shows their shoes. So, it seems to be a man's shoes right here. So the opening of the movie is shoes.
Awesome. Wonder what kind they are. Oh my god.
I know, it's. I'm enthralled already. This is.
We're gonna see his face.
I don't know. All we know is that we see someone's legs, and then there's shoes.
This is called the hook.
It should be like Jaws, where we don't see it until the very end, and then it gets blown up.
There you go. So anyway, we see shoes, and apparently it's someone walking towards a vehicle of some sort, and they get in the car. I guess maybe, I don't know, but I'm gonna skip ahead a little because this is kind of going nowhere right here.
This is the part where you would change channels, ladies and gentlemen.
See, the problem with indie openings is that they all start with feet. I don't know how many bad indie films I've seen that started with this exact same opening, where it starts with someone walking. And, you know, I've done this myself. I start a lot of my movies with someone walking. But usually I stop that about 5 seconds in, and something incredible happens, like nothing. Now, I want to state I'm criticizing this screenplay incredibly, except all the screenplays that I've written are horrible. So... So I'm not trying to put myself at a pedestal above this guy, because honestly I can't write drama any better than this, but I can certainly make fun of it.
Yes.
So
as can anyone.
Yes. So anyway, the whole first page is the guy's feet. So let's move on to the second page. Apparently
You're
there's
no
a guy
fun,
named Jack.
Jason.
I know. Apparently there's a guy named Jack. He's in his 30s. He's going into a grocery store. Okay. And are you enthralled, Matt? Is this
one guy goes into a grocery store?
I mean, while I'm drawing in Adobe Photoshop, I'm totally enthralled.
Now this is my favorite part. Okay, I'm on this Jack is in here, and this is the best part of bad writing. Okay, Jack goes up to someone and he mentions towards a worker at the grocery store, and taps on this worker's shoulder, and they're like. It actually says here, taken by surprise. The grocery. Yeah. And they say, they're basically like, what do you want? Yeah. And he's like, could you tell me how to get to this medicine that I need or whatever? I'm not going to say the dialogue exactly, because I don't want you to be surprised when you see this movie.
If you ever see it.
And then the grocery store person tells them where the thing is. So anyway, imagine watching this in video now. Okay, you've just spent about a minute watching this guy... This guy's feet, okay? And then watching this guy get out of a...
Literally a minute.
In and out of a car. And the first thing that happens in the movie is this person talks to a grocery store worker and asks where something is, and then they're directed to where something is. So we're not off to a good start. And this is not good.
Keep in mind, when you watch something in the movie theater or on TV, a minute goes by like that. Mm-hmm. Or it should, anyway. It should go by like that.
I don't think this will. I think this will be long and drawn out.
This will be like... This, the equivalent of, like, a minute on the page of this, or over that, is, like, dragging your nails, like, take, like, across, like, the chalkboard, or, like, bite your fork. Do something that would, like, you know, send chills down the back of your spine.
Probably gonna be
like,
black and white, too.
Yeah, and then, you know, something that would just make you want to go up to a doctor and go, would you please graft a baboon butt right onto my back? Because that would be more enthralling than watching this.
Let's go to the next page. Okay, so this guy goes and he buys some sore throat medicine.
He buys
some, like, lozenges or something. So we have a whole scene of him buying lozenges, okay?
Cool. Awesome.
Okay, so he goes, and it makes a note to say that he's confused by all the rest, by all the medicine. Like, there's so much medicine that he doesn't know what to get, and it takes him a second to find it.
So it's like a Keanu Reeves moment.
Wow. Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
So anyway, he goes and he gets this. Now this is just the worst writing in the world. He buys sore throat medicine, and then he comes home. And apparently he's kidnapped someone, because when he comes home, I guess there's someone here who's kidnapped and tied to a chair, this girl, and he got the sore throat medicine because she was screaming. I want you to all...
Wouldn't want to gag her or anything.
So he's kidnapped this girl and tied her to a chair, and we have a whole scene where he's going out and buying some lozenges. Because the person that he kidnapped was yelling.
This sounds like Joe trying to make himself sound like a nice guy for kidnapping Brookers.
You know, they say you put yourself in your writing.
It sounds like, you know, like, man, I would kidnap her, and, like, she would start screaming, then I'd be, like, all sweet, and I'd go get her cough medicine, and I'd be like, here, drink this, it'll make your throat feel better, and then she'd, like, totally fall in love with me.
Yeah.
Man, we are being such pricks tonight.
Oh,
this
God,
is worse
yes.
than the last one.
Oh, right.
Last time we were being stupid, now we're really just...
Well, we have a lot more to, you know, because this is when you have to be a little bit nicer when you're talking about someone's personal feelings, except when you're talking about someone's writing. I think
just bite into it like a juicy steak.
Yeah, exactly. Because honestly, I think because when I started doing movies, I did this movie called Orange, and it was about God and Satan fighting each other on Earth with handguns.
Tried watching it, couldn't.
Yeah, did I show part of it to you?
Yeah, you used to have it up on your websites back in the day.
A long time. Yeah, it was pretty bad, wasn't it?
You never showed me.
It was horrible. Except people in my family told me that it was good when they watched it. They were like, "Yeah, that's great." I really wish that they had just been like, "Jason, you know, I think you might have some talent, but you're not showing it. This is horrible. This is
what have you done, Jason?
This is terrible."
Took you like a year to make, right?
Well, only because I didn't have any of these the actors who were available. It took like 9 months between scenes in which they were available again at the same time.
I know
time.
Showed me some of the outtakes.
Yeah, it was
the guy kept on jumping on screen or something.
It was just a horrible movie, and so I think personally it's because it took me a long time after that until I started making comedies and found what I was actually decent at. But the thing is, if someone had told me sooner, why don't you try something else, then I might have started doing good stuff earlier. So
if you'd only met me sooner.
So this is why I have no problem giving scathing criticism to stuff that I hate.
Yeah.
So anyway,
I don't think she's gonna listen though.
Well, she didn't write this. Her live-in buddy did.
I don't know, but she's trying to sell it.
Yeah, I forget what character she's playing. I'll remember as we go on.
Oh, she's actually acting in this crap.
Yeah, she's acting in this movie.
Oh God. I wonder who she's gonna be.
I have no idea, but
she's
anyway.
She's one of the first female characters like that you see that curses a lot too.
Yeah, so totally. we switch to a dark alley. The next scene, we go from grocery store getting some cough syrup to
yum yum cough syrup
to a dark alleyway. Anyway, oh here she is, Ricky. Yeah, so Ricky is 17 years old, which works because she looks. I thought she was 12 when I first saw her. So she is younger, looks younger. Than... But anyway, she's dressed in gothic clothing, which is another sign of an indie film.
Goth, man. Goth.
Yeah, so she's dressed, and she's with her friend Kiara and Jade. And they're also dressed in goth clothing.
Oh my
God. So they start having conversations, and they're cursing a lot.
F it.
Yeah, the Kiara's first line actually has three curse words in it. And four. Sorry. Let me one.
F these effing effers.
Yeah, actually, she says, I'm gonna put this kinder for the radio, but she says something to the tune of, I informed this person that I would fornicate with whomever I please.
Fornicate? You said fornicate, man.
The original language was somewhat more intense.
Yeah.
And so anyway, Ricky starts cursing too.
Yeah, you're effing right.
Reminds me of an ex-girlfriend I once had.
F yeah.
So I guess they go to a club now. I don't know how this happened, but apparently they're at a club. And there's a bouncer.
Dude.
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly how this transitioned here. I must have missed something.
We should go get totally messed up. Yeah.
Okay, their description of the club is pretty great. It mentions that the club is dark. The club is it's very loud in the club.
What?
That's very descriptive.
Trying to get it.
So apparently these people are at a club now.
It's loud, but it's dark. So not only can you food? Not hear, but you
Jason,
run into there, things.
Jason, is there drinks?
I'm assuming there's like club sandwiches and stuff.
But there's drinks and sandwiches, but you have to find them. Because it's dark and loud.
Okay, so anyway, they're here and they're in the club, and I guess they
What's
go to
going
the,
on now?
I think they go to the bathroom to do drugs, but I'm not yeah, heroin. There we go.
There we go. It must be hard finding the vein in a dark club like that.
No, well, they go to the bathroom, so maybe the bathroom is more light.
Oh.
So immediately, we're on page 7 here, and already they're doing heroin, and there's a kidnapped girl, and I'm not sure what's going on, but page 7, that means about 7 minutes into the movie.
Yeah.
And so we're at the drug
They went to the club just to go to the bathroom to get high.
Yeah, well, you know, you can't do heroin, like, anywhere else. You have to be at a club, man.
Yeah, man.
Well, I'm sorry, I'm not cool.
So, yeah.
I do my heroin in the 7-Elevens.
TV teaches me that I should block TV shows that use drugs on TV.
Now, what's interesting now is this is interesting, because we're on page 7, and the whole page is just, there's no dialogue, it's just descriptions of what's going on. And then I go to page 8.
Anyone's like that, too.
I go to page 8, and it's the same thing. Page 9 is the same thing, no dialogue, just description. they make a point to make sure that you know that Beethoven's 9th Symphony is playing as this is happening, which is another sign of an indie film.
Ricky does heroin. Ricky does more heroin. Beethoven's
page
9th Symphony
10 is the same thing,
Ricky
it's all action. Page 11 is the same thing. And finally, on page 12, we have another line of dialogue, and there's a guy named Jack saying the F word. That's
yeah.
it. That's all the dialogue at page 12.
This reminds me of that movie Go. Did you ever see that movie?
No.
Yeah, it was a lot like this. Only it was ecstasy, not heroin.
So I'm not exactly sure what's happening here. I think she's doing drugs and in the bathroom. And I don't know exactly what happens. I think someone got stabbed. I'm not sure.
You can tell we gave up on this script like right after page 2 or 3.
Yeah,
so did NBC.
I don't know. Exactly. NBC did not get to this part. They saw the first scene, saw it was all about feet, and decided,
walking.
Yeah, this is. Well, honestly, if I was an NBC executive, because they see hundreds of scripts every week, and you know what to look for, and that's exactly what you look for to throw away.
Yeah, this is what it sounded like. Tammy? Yes, Mr. Banfield? Could you bring me the shredder? The one for the big scripts? Yeah, that's the one. Thanks. And a coffee. And a donut.
This
okay,
sucks.
Wait, well, this is... I'm on page 10, and they have a great, man, I wish I could just read this whole thing, because it's... The writing here, just the wording of everything is hilarious.
I'd like to go watch grass grow.
But anyway, so I guess someone got stabbed or something, I don't know, but we're on page,
I've been stabbed.
I'm not...
Wait, we're going...
No, let's go to page 13.
13.
Yeah.
What's on page 13?
Hold on a second.
Sup? Sup?
I think he, like, had a potty emergency.
What's up?
Oh. Yeah, I'm back. No, my microphone stand was moving down.
See, even your microphone stand is trying to get the hell away from the script.
Yeah, I know.
Like, dive!
So anyway, something is happening. I guess Ricky wakes up and it's in the morning, and...
Every time I hear Ricky, I just think Ricky Bobby from Talladega Nights.
So Ricky, which is who Brooker plays, is...
Ricky Bobby.
She wakes up.
You gotta feel the road, Ricky Bobby.
Yeah. She wakes up and her parents are yelling at her.
Do the dishes! And I just want to get high, Mom.
So anyway, the dialogue.
Why can't you let me do YouTube movies and just get high?
I so wish that I could just read through all this, because it would be a lot funnier.
I know it would.
The dialogue itself is just so lame, and it's. I'll give you an example. But I'm not actually going to read it, but I'm going to improvise some dialogue as Ricky's mother.
Okay,
I'm Ricky's mother, and Knox. Next, you're going to be Ricky here, okay?
Okay, I haven't read the script, but okay.
Well, you don't have to say anything. I'm just... Know that I'm talking to you.
Okay.
Okay? Ricky! Ricky, what are you doing? Don't talk to me like that, Ricky. Ricky, you were always a good kid, Ricky. But now your life is changing and you're becoming a different person, and I don't want it to... I don't want your life to be bad. I want it to be good. You used to be so good and you had so much potential, and now you're...
The opposite of good.
Yes.
Shut up, Mom.
I'm tired of your attitude that you have, and your weird clothing, and your eyeliner.
I want to eat your face.
But yeah, that's pretty much how the dialogue goes.
You don't understand me, Jason.
It's like that, only said seriously and with different words.
Words that are curses.
Yeah.
Forbidden.
Ricky is a badass.
That is one tough badass.
So anyway, they have a fight. They have a fight that sounds pretty boring and totally forced. None of this is...
Seeing as we don't even know these characters yet.
I have no idea what's going on.
See, I don't even know who Ricky is yet. That's
we're like 20 minutes into the movie, and I still don't know who anyone is or what's going on.
I don't give a crap about Ricky.
I don't even understand what the kidnap person in the beginning was about.
I hate you. You never love me, and you never will. Door slams. Beethoven music, or whatever the hell it was before, starts playing again. Insert heroin needle. Insert three more pages of
insert feet.
Hallucination. Insert more feet. We need more feet.
More feet.
Yeah, so anyway, people are starting to cry here. I'm on page 17, and people are crying. And then I guess, I think we might be back at the kidnapper's place. I'm not sure exactly what's happening.
Welcome to my kidnapping lair.
The kidnapper, I think, might be drinking milk. I guess that's supposed to show that he's creepy, because only creepy people drink milk.
That's right. Milk is bad. You should drink soy milk.
I think this is... No, this might not be. No, this might not be the kidnapper.
I thought Jack was the kidnapper.
Yeah, Jack is the kidnapper. This is not Jack. Michael is drinking milk.
Oh.
But Jack is in the same place, though.
Jack
is asleep on... Yeah, Jack is on the couch.
I mean, he's asleep on the couch.
And here is... okay, here's the kidnapped girl again. Okay, she's still kidnapped. Okay, so... I guess she gets free or something. She's trying to get free. I don't know if she succeeds. Let me read down here. And, hey, the music stopped. I have to restart it. Hold on.
It's the script, Jason.
I know.
The kidnapped lady is trying to get out of the script, too.
Okay,
what page are you on?
I'm in page 21.
Oh. Man, you guys are way ahead of me. Okay.
We're at another section in which there's like five pages without dialogue.
Oh.
So I don't know if she escaped or not. I think she did.
That crafty dog.
No, wait. No.
No.
She almost escaped.
Oh my god, it's like something out of Silence of the Lambs.
He captures her again.
I was on the edge of my seat.
So we had five pages of her trying to escape and then getting put back again. So
failing
five pages later and nothing was accomplished.
Loser.
Okay, so I guess Ricky's back.
Ricky Bobby.
And this is great because the last time we saw Ricky, she woke up and had a fight with her parents. Now she's in bed, she wakes up, and her parents come in, she has a fight with them.
I hate you, Mom and Dad, I hate you.
Okay, so here we... okay, we're back at Michael's now.
What page?
23.
Yeah, tell me when we go to the pages.
I'm gonna go to 24 now.
I like heroin bugs on the beach.
I don't even know what's going on in this anymore. This is...
Not music.
It's just absolutely nothing interesting is happening, and it's 24 pages in, and it's exactly the same stuff that has been happening for the last 24 pages.
You can call me at 555-565.
This is like the worst movie... script, because it's... Alright, so we're at page 24
we're like
now.
We're halfway through this thing.
Yeah, I know, and...
Nothing's going on.
Well, some stuff is going on, it's just nothing that people would want to watch.
Maybe it's a pilot. Maybe we gotta, like, tune in. Tune in next week for the exciting adventures of Ricky, the heroin addict.
Okay, so here is...
Will she evade the psychotic kidnapper who gets her costume up when she feels yucky?
People are cursing again.
More cursing. More action.
That's
more
all they say.
Heroin.
I guess it's again when people don't know how to write good intense dialogue, they just They just put as many,
I don't really know what you call it, being Giuseppe, whatever the hell my last name is.
Here's one of Jack's line, okay? Blank, F word, blank, blank. Blank, 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 F word, blank, 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 F word, blank, 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 S word, blank, blank.
Sure, she's not writing for HBO.
This is some hard-hitting dialogue right here, and it's not her writing, again, it's the guy. Okay, S word.
Brookers, you need to,
I guess they might have
shack
kidnapped
up with
her.
A new stalker.
They're talking about money now, so they might have kidnapped her.
Wait, who's I have nothing to money. Contribute other than, like, you know...
I'm on page 26 now.
Oh, me too. You need to tell me when you switch pages. You keep on going on without me.
Ricky is apparently sneaking out of her house now on page 27.
Oh, that little.
Now, it mentions specifically that Ricky is now in a bad neighborhood.
Ricky Bobby.
So
get out myself, sorry.
So now we know that she's in a bad neighborhood.
She's in a bad neighborhood, and... I don't know where this is going. I just...
He punishes her for being bad by giving her heroin and cough syrup.
I don't know who the girl is. I maybe if I actually read more of this, but it's just... It's so hard. Because
it's so hard.
It is.
I want to stab my eyes out.
All right, so I guess he's untying Jack. We're back to Jack now, and he's untying the girl, I guess.
The girl of his dreams.
And, okay, she's asking questions now, which is, I think, the first time anyone's asked why anything is going on in this movie.
Why are you kidnapping me?
Yeah, exactly. And he says, it's for money.
Because I can. Shut up.
And apparently he's had her kidnapped for 6 months.
What page are we on?
This is a slow ransom job. We're on page 29.
Why are you doing this? My parents were kidnapped.
Oh my god. This dialogue is amazing.
What?
I so wish I could read all this on page 29. Go halfway down with Jack. Don't read it, but...
Okay.
Now you got me one sealed. Hold on a second.
Go to page 29 and halfway down the page.
I know, I'm reading it.
I can just imagine this guy talking like... Bah, bah, bah. Like, I'm gonna paraphrase this. Yeah, well, you know, the job should have gone better. It should have gone to plan, and everything could have been back to how it was. But that didn't happen. Now we gotta work this out now for just a while, just a bit more. My partner. My partner, apparently there's an informant, and we were tipped off.
And yet I haven't been caught.
Yeah, so yes. I mean that's how the dialogue is going, and it's bad.
This sucks. Do they go into space? Does anybody go into space in this movie?
I doubt it.
Are they all really? Is this all like really just astronaut training?
The only way we can get out of this together, and me not go to jail, and you not go back to your parents, is if we go to the moon.
Yeah, isn't this... Maybe so there's another just five... astronaut training for dealing with ready aliens.
There's another 5 pages of description, which is really boring to read through because nothing interesting is happening.
Oh, damn it.
I guess Ricky might have done more drugs. I'm not sure.
Ricky Bobby.
I have a feeling Ricky is going to get kidnapped at some point. I'm not sure. If she hasn't already, I can't tell what's going on.
What page are we on?
I don't know. I'm just scrolling through. I'm on page 34 now.
Thank God we're almost through this thing. We're gonna make it together, Knox.
I think the kidnapped girl is dying now.
I don't feel so good.
I don't know. I'm not sure what happened here.
Why is she dying?
I don't know.
Maybe that cough syrup wasn't really cough syrup.
Oh man, this is... This is really bad. I'm going to skip through some of this. We'll skip through a lot of this.
I did it because I love you. You know I love you.
Okay, so here's Ricky again.
What page?
I'm just scrolling through. I'm just reading with... Kidnapped
Don't
girl.
Be such a sissy.
Kidnapped girl.
Kidnapped girl. Just drink the rat poison.
Drink it. Drink it because you love me.
We have some flashbacks, which is always good.
Yeah, flashback.
Are they flashback into a character development?
I think there's a... Oh, man, I think there's like a surprise here.
What? Where?
I don't understand. I'm on page, it's 43.
For all of you who are bored of this, like I am.
This is great. This character, Jack, on page 44, he just realizes some shocking twist, and he actually says, "Wait!"
And wait, he's a like, second?
Exactly. And then he explains everything. So apparently Susan, who's a character I don't understand here.
You know her name is not Susan.
I think Michael and Susan are brothers.
Huh? I'm really a guy.
No, all right. Wait a minute.
Michael and sister are siblings. Sorry.
Now it all makes sense.
Sorry, I misworded that.
All those nights that you were together.
And I guess Michael was in on it all the time. Whatever he's in on, I don't know.
Who the hell's Michael?
I don't know, actually. Okay, now Jack is freaking out, and because apparently Susan know each other.
Susan's a dude.
Okay, so Susan is Michael's sister. I don't know if that means anything, but
Susan is Michael's sister's
best
friend's
cousin's roommate.
That'll
probably ruin it for anyone who's going to watch this.
I don't think anybody's going to watch this, Jason.
Ever.
What page are you on?
Susan might be the kidnapped chick. I'm not sure.
Until no one's gonna watch it until Brookers comes back to her senses and does this as a YouTube video set in installments of 2 minutes each.
What the heck?
Is this turning into like a bad mystery movie?
Jack, the kidnapper, is a cop?
What?
I don't know. It's page 45. Suddenly he's like.
Hi, Sarge. Kind of funny.
No, he's not.
Wait,
he's not a cop. He's a private investigator.
No, even worse.
Wait, I don't get it. I thought he kidnapped.
I've been following you for a long time, Bobby.
Pretty pissed off cop.
I'm going to eat your face.
I don't understand this. So he kidnapped. Wait, he's a private investigator. What is going on? It's just like, it's like, you know, when people try to write like M. Night Shyamalan endings
Shyamalan
and stuff, where they throw like all of these twists in there that aren't actually interesting.
Hey-o.
When's this show gonna air?
I don't think it ever is, honestly.
No, not that show. This show.
What show?
The show that we're doing.
Oh, Tuesday.
The one that we're on.
This Tuesday?
Yeah.
Every Tuesday. Every Tuesday, Matt.
Okay. That, just to let you know, that it's going to be a big day for all 8 million World of Warcraft subscribers.
I think Jack just killed someone.
What did he kill? Well, that's a
I think Jack killed Susan.
The expansion!
We're at the end here, and Jack kills Susan.
Wait, it's going to get even bigger.
The last page?
More life-consuming, more cancerous to society.
This movie sucks. I don't know what's
more
going on.
More Korean people will die from not eating or sleeping.
Ricky and her mother are fighting again.
Why are they fighting? Are they there?
I don't think they are actually. And Jack is still alive though.
No one's really.
I thought Jack was the bad guy, but apparently not. I don't know. What the heck? Go to the very last page.
The last page?
Yeah, go to the very last page and read the top line right there. The top lines.
Last page.
Very, very last page, and read the very first descriptive dialogue here in all caps.
What the hell is this? I don't get it.
Apparently, okay, so what, Jack just... Remember at the very beginning of the movie, there was that person at the grocery store that Jack asked for the lozenges from. Apparently, the very end of the movie, the big ending twist, is he's now kidnapped that person.
Wow.
The person who was in the movie at the very beginning for like a second, who directed him to the throat medicine is now in his trunk.
I think this guy wrote Jack after he watched Sin City and watched The Yellow Bastard.
Probably.
I don't think anybody's going to remember that character an hour ago.
I don't understand how this is any... Man, I don't understand how that makes sense at all.
The car drives off into the sunset. Fade to black.
That's what we're missing.
In credits.
So we give this script a 2 thumbs down. And between us, I guess that's 6 thumbs.
Knoxkast Radio gives this script a 1.
Yeah, so this was pretty bad.
Out of 5.
So if you see the commercial for a movie called Roundabout, stay away from it.
Yeah, do not watch Roundabout.
Instead, go to brookersucks.com.
Yeah, we actually have a few more submissions that I have yet to put up that I just got emails for. I think we have probably about 4 or 5 extra videos. We're still getting them in. But, God, Roundabout.
Thanks, Brookers. Thanks.
Man, you know, I really wish that I could just put this online for everyone and just let them read through, because it is fun. It's like, you know, the movies that you see on Mystery Science Theater.
Yeah.
It's like that you can just read through it and just laugh the whole time. You people are missing out.
Oh, no, I don't think it would be seen anywhere else.
You people
Maybe
are missing
can,
out.
Give him $100 to let us put it up online.
I'd like to license your film.
I don't think it's worth $100, though. Maybe
we want to license it just to make fun of it a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think this is one of those times where we could do the script exactly how it is and turn it into a comedy without changing a word. Without changing a single word, it could be a comedy.
Could. You can do better than this, Brookers.
Return to sender, Brookers.
So yeah, brookersucks.com.
I'm disappointed in you.
Much fear I sense in you, Brookers.
Can't believe this crap is copyrighted.
Well, anything you make is copyrighted.
This crap shouldn't be copyrighted.
Like if I know, you smear poop on a piece of toilet paper, and if you consider it art, it's copyrighted.
That's a good analogy for this.
Hey, put his phone number up there. We should call him.
Yeah, we should call him and tell him what we think of his script. that's another reason why we can't release this.
Yeah. He has his address and phone number. That would be awesome.
I wonder if we can get him on the air.
Doubt it. He's probably such a hardcore Brookers fan. He'd be like, "You're the devil."
Hey, Mike. We can. We'll see here. I doubt if this guy's ever going to hear this episode. But if he does, we would love to have you on the show to defend your work. We'll give him a full chance to explain it, because obviously we don't get it.
Yes. No.
Obviously we don't get the script.
We don't get this kind of comedy.
So if he wants to come on and explain exactly why it doesn't suck, then he has every opportunity. Just send us an email.
Maybe Brookers, that would be better too. Maybe both of them.
Yeah, I seriously doubt if she wants to come on.
She wants to slit your throat.
She's not getting work anywhere else. Why wouldn't she? Don't kill me.
That's kind of hard.
If Brooks can last without killing me, the show can you, Brookers.
It's rough. You can do it, though, Brookers. If I can do it, you can do it.
Yeah. So I hope you've enjoyed our review of this classic.
We didn't.
This classic literature.
Because we didn't.
Yeah, it was a pain for us. Very painful experience.
It's probably the final Brookers episode, right?
Yeah, this is probably the last we're going to do on this, unless something else big comes up.
We're going to piss a lot of people off at this episode.
I mean, honestly...
Gotta fire back.
I die. None of this is interesting enough to warrant this much attention. But,
I hear typing. Sorry.
Yeah.
Brooks!
I hate you.
Oh,
why don't you go suck on your water bottle some more, huh? I've been listening to that the whole show.
Water, bro? What the hell? I don't drink water.
Soda, then.
Water's for wussies.
Tooth-rotten soda.
My teeth are okay.
That's not as good as great, though.
I can eat chicken wings with them, so that, you know, that's all that matters to me.
But can you put them away when you're not using them?
No.
Okay, then they're okay.
How do you know I was drinking soda the whole time?
As you said, you're not drinking water.
I mean, how'd you know I was sucking on the bottle the whole time?
Because I can hear it.
How'd you know it wasn't Jason?
Because Jason has better mic etiquette than you.
He didn't... He never got off the bottle. He's a baby.
He's a baby.
Goo goo. Jason.
Yeah.
A Gucci Gucci goo.
Yeah, Gucci goo.
A Gucci
die
Gucci
hard
goo.
4, guys. Live free or die hard. Ugh.
Do you like it when I tickle your tummy?
Alright, well, this has been Knoxkast episode 33. I hope you've all had a fun and jolly time.
And thanks for making me read this, Jason.
I know. So yeah, we'll talk to you later, guys.
And remember, keep sending your supreme in your overlord is watching.
Wait. Don't stop sending the videos.
Listening.
Feeling. Don't ever stop.
Sensing. Smelling.
Don't ever stop.
Oh, they won't.
Never. Moderating.
Never.
They won't.
Never.
Inspiring. Jason, your unsupreme overlord is having a movement.
I'm talking to a bottle, yeah.
That's enough of that silliness. It's time to end the show.
It's time to end Knoxkast.
Bye, everyone.
Knoxkast.